சோ கார்பன் அண்ட் காம்பவுண்ட்ஸ் லெசன் வந்து கண்டினியூ பண்றோம் ஓகே சோ நேத்து நான் கொடுத்த ஹோம்வொர்க் போன கிளாஸ்ல வந்து क्वेश्चन நம்பர்
10
CH3CL ஓகே சோ CH3CL ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் வந்து இட் will be like this சோ CH3CL ஓகே சோ கார்பனுக்கு வந்து 4 டாட்ஸ் 1 2 3 4 ஓகே சோ ஈச் ஹைட்ரஜனுக்கு ஒரு ஒரு டாட் அண்ட் குளோரின் குளோரினோட அட்டாமிக் நம்பர் வந்து 17 சோ இட் will be arranged as 287 we have to keep 7 டாட்ஸ் ஃபார் குளோரின் சோ 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 ஓகே 7 டாட்ஸ் சோ hydrogen we will circle first 2 dots carbon 1 2 3 4 okay fifth dot sixth dot seventh dot eighth dot okay 8 dots okay and chlorine 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and eighth electron it will share from carbon okay so totally it is having 1 2 3 4 4 covalent bonds and all the four covalent bonds are single bonds so four covalent bonds and all the bonds are single bonds okay so the last one which we studied is the name of this compound is chloromethane okay so the next one which I gave you is CH3CH2CH3 is propane so CH3 means it will be connected like this so CH3CH2 it will be connected like this and then CH3 so CH3 CH2 CH3 okay so for each carbon we will keep 4 dots 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 okay and we will keep 1 dot for hydrogens okay so we have to keep 1 dots for hydrogens so it is easy to circle for hydrogen first okay so for all the hydrogens you have to circle 2 dots okay and for carbon now so this carbon is already having 4 electrons 5 6 7 and 8 you have to circle this carbon is already having 4 electrons so 5 6 7 and 8 you have to circle this carbon is already having 4 electrons so 5 6 7 and 8 you have to circle okay so 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 so there are 10 covalent bonds there are 10 covalent bonds and all the 10 bonds are single bonds all the 10 bonds are single bonds okay so with this we are completing the electron dot structures of all the molecules okay so now we are going to the next topic of the lesson okay so the next topic of the lesson is IUPAC naming IUPAC naming of carbon compounds IUPAC naming of carbon compounds so how will you write find out the names of the carbon compounds that is what we are going to study okay so the IUPAC naming of carbon compounds so for this you have to by heart a tabular column which I am going to write now okay so it will be easy for you so first tabular column is number of carbon atoms number of carbon atoms and what is the prefix you will use for that? Number of carbon atoms and what is the prefix you will use for that? So listen carefully. So if the compound is having one carbon atom, okay, if the compound is having one carbon atom, you have to use the prefix meth. If the compound is having two carbon atoms, you have to use the prefix eth. If it is three carbon atoms, you have to use the prefix pro. If it is four carbon atoms, you have to use the prefix but. Okay, you should not call it as but, it is but. Okay, if it is five, you have to use pent, and if it is six, you have to use hex. So after six alone, it is enough for your 10th standard syllabus. Okay, so if the compound is having one carbon atom, meth, two eth, three pro, four but, five pent, six hex. Okay, now about suffix. The suffix we will decide based on the bond. The suffix we will divide based on the bond. If the compound is having only single bond, okay, then we should use the suffix ane. We should use the suffix ane. If the compound is having double bond, you have to use the suffix ene. Okay, if the compound is having triple bond, you have to use the suffix ine. Okay, single bond ane, double bond ene, triple bond ine. Okay, clear? Now the next one, if any group comes in the branch, so for the branched groups, for the branched groups, if any group comes in the branch, for the branched groups, you have to add the suffix yl. You have to add the suffix yl. Okay, suppose if the compound is a cyclic compound, suppose if the compound is a cyclic compound, you should add the prefix cyclo. You should add the prefix cyclo. So understood? So yes. This one you have to by heart, only then you can name the compounds. Okay, so this when you see you cannot understand, but we work out, when we work out the examples, you can understand it. Okay, so for branched group, YL is the suffix, and for cyclic compounds, cyclo is the prefix. Okay, prefix means you have to add in the front, suffix means you have to add behind. Okay, so we will start naming with simple CH4. How many carbons are there?
One
carbon. So one carbon means it is meth. So one carbon means it is meth. Can you see any double bond here? No double bond. Can you see any triple bond here? No triple bond. So double bond is not there, triple bond is not there. Then it means it is having only single bond. So single bond means what is the suffix I have to add?
A.
So what is the name of this compound?
Methane.
Understood? Have you got?
Yes,
the
sir.
Next one. CH3. Single bond CH3. How many carbons are there?
Two
carbons are there. Two carbons means it is eth. So eth. So what bond is there in the center? Single bond. So single bond means what you have to add?
Ane.
So the name of this compound is ethane. Okay, the name of this compound is ethane. Now third one. CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH3. Okay. So how many carbons are there?
Three
carbons are there. So three carbons means what is the prefix?
Pro.
Okay, so it is pro, and all are single bonds. So single bond means it is ane is the suffix. So it is propane. Understood? Have you got propane? Yes. Now Suppose if they give the name and if they ask you to draw the structure. For example, if they ask what is the structure for butane. If they ask like this, what is the structure for butane? How to draw that you should know. So first, what is given? Bute. Bute means how many carbons? How many carbons for bute? Four carbons. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Draw four carbons first. Next, what is given? Ane. Yes or no? So ane means what? Single bond. So in between all the carbons, you have to put single bond between all the carbons. Now carbon, you know the valency of carbon is 4. So always carbon will form 4 bonds. Okay. So if you see this carbon, it is already having one bond. Remaining how many bond it needs? It needs remaining 3 bonds. Already it is having one bond. Remaining it needs 3 bonds. So you have to put 3 hydrogens. Okay. This carbon, this side it is having one bond and this side it is having one bond. So two bonds it is already there. Okay. So remaining how many bond it needs? Two more bond it needs. So for that, how many hydrogens I have to put? Two hydrogens I have to put. Okay. So this carbon, it is already having two bonds. So it needs how many more bonds? Two more bonds. So I have to put two hydrogens. What about this carbon? It is having only one bond. Remaining it needs 3 bonds. So for that we have to put how many hydrogens? 3 hydrogens. So what will be the structure of butane? Tell me. CH3. Next. CH2. CH2. CH3. So this is my structure of butane. Understood how to name? And if the name is given, how to draw the structure? Okay, clear? But they will not ask such easy questions in the exam. Okay, so in the exam, how they will ask? Okay, that we need to study now. Okay, so this also they will not ask, but it's okay. CH2, double bond CH2. How will you name this? How many carbons are there? Two carbons are there. So two carbons means it is ethyl. Two carbons means it is ethyl. And double bond is there. Double bond is there means ene. So what is the name of this compound? Ethene. Okay, what is the name of this compound? Ethene. Okay. Next, can you write the name for this one? It is very easy. So how many carbons are there? Two carbons. Two carbons means it is ethyl. Triple bond is there. Triple bond means it is ene, Y-N-E. Okay, so what is the name of this compound? Ethyne. What is the name of this compound? Ethyne. Okay, but they will not ask easy questions like this also in the board exam. Okay, so in the board exam, how they will ask? So that type of questions I will start doing now. Seventh one. CH3, CH, double bond, CH2. So if they ask, give a question like this, how to name this? Okay, so first, put down your pens and then listen. How many carbons are there? Three carbons. So three carbons means it is pro. So first I am writing pro. Three carbons, so pro. Okay, here single bond also is there, double bond also is there. Okay, single bond also is there, double bond also is there. So always we should give preference for the higher bond. Higher bond means we should give preference for the double bond. So double bond means what is the prefix here? Here it is having single bond and double bond. So we should give preference for the double bond and we should write ene. We should write ene. Okay, but in which carbon the double bond is present, that position also we have to mention. The position of the double bond also we should mention. So what is the question given? CH3, CH, double bond, CH2. So for mentioning the position of the double bond, we have to number the carbons. So you have to number the carbons from this side, and also you have to number the carbons from this side. So if I number from this side, 1, 2, 3. If I number from that side, 1, 2, 3. So now you see the position, okay? If you number from this side, the double bond, it is attached in the second carbon. It is attached in the which carbon? Second carbon. If you number from this side, if you see from this side, the double bond is attached in the first carbon. From that side, if you see, the double bond is attached in the first carbon. From this side, if you see, the double bond is attached in the second carbon. So always you should take the position which is having the least number. So 2 is the least number or 1 is the least number? 1. So I should write pro-1-ene. This is the name of the compound. So what is the name of the compound? Pro-1-ene. Okay. In between the words and the numbers, you should put hyphen mark. Okay, pro-1-ene. So next we will do one more example like this. Suppose if I get a compound like this, CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH2, CH3. So how will you write the name of this compound? How many carbons are there?
Four
carbons are there. So I should write bute. Okay. So here double bond also is there, single bond also is there. But I will give preference to the double bond and I will write ene. So now what I should do? I should mention the position of the double bond. For that what I should do? I should number from this side and I should number from this side. So this side 1, 2, 3, 4. From this side 1, 2, 3, 4. If I see from this side, the double bond is attached in the first carbon, number 1. If I see from this side, the double bond is attached in the third carbon. So which is the least number, 1 or 3?
1.
1 is the least number. So 1 only you should take. Bute-1-ene is the name of this compound. Okay. Next question. CH3, CH, double bond, CH, CH3. So how to name this compound? So totally there are 4 carbons. So 4 carbons means what is the prefix you have to use? 4 carbons means you have to use the prefix bute. Okay. So single bond also is present, double bond also is present. We will give importance only for the double bond. So ene. Now I have to mention the position of the double bond. So number from this side and then number from this side. Okay, from both the sides if you have to number. Okay, so when I number from this side, the double bond is attached to the second carbon. When I number from this side also, the double bond is attached to the second carbon. Both the sides we are getting number 2 only, so we can write 2 itself. Bute-2-ene. Okay, bute-2-ene. So this is bute-1-ene, this is bute-2-ene. So simply if you write butene, it is wrong. Okay, because in butene itself there are two types, bute-1-ene and bute-2-ene. Instead of writing bute-1-ene, you can also write it as 1-butene. Or you can write this as 2-butene. This one 1-propene, like that also you can write. Okay. Now suppose if you get the question like this. CH2 double bond CH, CH double bond CH2. I am getting a question like this. How will you name the compound? So how many carbons are there? You have 4 carbons. So 4 carbons means it is bute. Okay. Now single bond also is present. Double bond also is present. We will give preference to the double bond. So double bond I am giving preference, so I am writing ene. but here and all we are having only one double bond. Here how many double bonds I am having?
Two
double bond. Two double bond means I have to put the prefix diene. Okay, if there are three double bonds, I have to write triene. If there are four double bonds, I have to write tetraene. Okay, so like that it will go on. So how many double bonds are here? Two double bonds. So I have to write it as diene. Okay, so when there was only one double bond, only for that double bond you wrote the position. But here how many double bonds are there? Two double bonds are there. So for both the double bonds you have to write the position. So number from this side 1 2 3 4, and then number from this side 1 2 3 4. Okay, so when I number from this side, this double bond is getting the number 1 and this double bond is getting the number 3. So I am getting 1 comma 3 when I number this side. When I number from this side, I am getting 1 for this double bond and I am getting 3 for this double bond. So this side if I number also, I am getting 1 comma 3. So 1 comma 3 is the position, so I can write 1 comma 3. Don't take 1 from this numbering and 1 from this numbering, and don't write but 1 die, that is wrong. Both the numbers you have to take from the same side only. Okay, don't take one number from this side and one number from opposite side, that is wrong. So but 1,3-diene is the name of this compound. Okay, so I will give a name, you try to find the structure of the compound. Okay, so pent-2-ene, you try to write the structure of pent-2-ene. So pent means first 5 carbons you have to put, 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, in the second position ene means double bond. So in the second carbon 1 2, in the second carbon you have to put double bond. So in all the other carbons you will put single bond. Now you have to fill hydrogens. So this carbon is having only one bond, remaining it needs 3 bonds, so I am putting 3 hydrogens. Okay, this carbon, this side it is having 1, this side 2, 3. 3 bonds it is having. Remaining it needs only 1 bond. So only 1 hydrogen I will put. Okay. So this carbon also it is having 1, 2, 3 bonds. So remaining only 1 bond it needs. So I will put only 1 hydrogen. So this carbon it is having 2 bonds. So 2 hydrogens I will put. This carbon is having only 1 bond. So I will put remain 3 bond it needs, so I will put 3 hydrogens. So what will be my structure formula? CH3CH, then double bond CH, okay, single bond CH2, single bond CH3. This will be my formula for pent-2-ene. Okay, pent-2-ene. So you can draw only the structure, no need to draw electron dot structure. Okay. So next question, 12th one. Suppose if I get a compound like this, CH3, CH, 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 CH2. Suppose if I get a compound like this, how will I name this compound? Okay. So first 1 2 3 4 5, 5 carbons are there. So 5 carbons means you have to add the prefix pent. 5 carbons means you have to add the prefix pent. So pent, okay, so single bond also is there, double bond also is there. We will give preference only to the double bond. So double bond means it is ene. But how many double bonds are there? We have 2 double bonds. So 2 double bond means I have to add diene. 2 double bond means I have to add diene. Okay. So now I have to mention the position of both the bonds. Okay. So number from this side and then number from this side. If I number from this side, okay, the double bond, this double bond is getting the number 2 and this double bond is getting the number 4. So I am getting 2 comma 4. If I number from this side, this double bond is getting the number 1, this double bond is getting the number 3, 1 comma 3, okay. So I am getting 2 comma 4, 1 comma 3. So which pair you will choose? The pair which is having the least number, lesser number, that pair only you should choose. So here the lesser number is 1. So you have to choose the pair 1 comma 3. Okay, so pen 1 comma 3 die in. Okay, you should not choose 2 comma 4. You should choose 1 comma 3. Don't choose 1 from here and 2 from here. And don't write it as 1 comma 2. It is wrong. Okay. So 1 comma 3 dying. Okay. So with this I am completing for today. So the remaining things we will continue in the next class.